toes down. Pretty good arm swing. Kind of a gray morning. So get the feet together, just lifting off the heels, rising the shoulders at the same time. Then really tighten sole. You may notice a difference, you may not. Okay, how about a nice big stretch, take a deep breath. We need to get some work going for the muscles of the chest. Just bring the arms forward, simple move. So in this case, with both arms moving at the same time, we're getting the muscles all the way across the chest. So very basic move, but very effective because again, each time the arms come in toward the center and forward or upward and across the center. Excuse me, it's one of those mornings. So, it's getting those muscles working. Get the hands together. Just let the fingers barely interlace. Pressing forward, so palms are together. Just kind of watch what's happening with the arms. And you see that the arms are coming forward, the elbows are coming in closer to each other. So you want to take those arms pretty much fully straight, just about chest level. They don't have to go any higher than that. It's going to be basically the same effect if the arms are lower. It's just that, you know, this is probably the optimal position. Bring those arms down. Just let them swing nice and easy. So even this very relaxed and casual move with the arm, there's still a little bit of work there for the pectoral muscles, just not as much. Put the arm forward, put the palm down, little turn with the shoulder. So that's not as direct an effect on those muscles, but it's still, you know, it still has brought the arm in a little bit. So down, palm up. That's going to catch that muscle a little bit more. Thumb up, not so much unless you bring the arm in across a little bit more. And then you can feel the difference. So thumb up, just coming forward. A little bit of work there. But thumb up, in across, back to place. That one really draws on that muscle. Puts it to work. And of course, muscles across the chest and muscles at the upper back. You know, like biceps and triceps. Muscles at the upper chest, muscles at the upper back, the two opposing teams. So, when you bring the arm across, concentrating more on the chest, bringing the arm even just too straight forward, a little bit of work there for the upper back. Okay, let's just get those. So the hands are coming in under the crook of the elbow. A little stretch there for the other side of the upper arm. This is not really super contraction of those muscles across the chest, but when you look at where your arms are, where your elbows are, you're a little bit more toward the center. So just a little bit of a slide shift, side to side. Each time those arms move, it's changing the configuration in terms of what those muscles across the chest are doing. It could be a super complicated thing with the swing. It just needs to be a change of direction. So obviously we have upper arms involved here, shoulders involved here. That little slide or shift side to side can be a little bit different work on those pectorals. Not so much for the upper back here, other than the fact that it's providing support. Bring the arms down, loosen them up. We'll raise off the heels. Got a little cardio here, pretty easy. That position with the arms provided quite a bit of stretch along the outer side and the upper portion of the arm. So, probably feels pretty good to get those arms relaxing. We need some work for the back. We've got a little bit going here as the arms come down and toward the back. Now, if you take the roll, rumble it and get it at the back with arms raised to the back. So, straight elbows, arms raised. Hold that position. Try to keep the shoulders relaxed. Try to keep the shoulders down because they're probably going to want to tighten up and so we want those elbows straight, just a little tension on the rope. And because we're not moving at this point, this is basically an isometric exercise. Isometric is a non-moving move, basically. So you're not going to take this any farther. You're just going to keep those arms in that position and then let them relax. Again, just a little raise, holding, you can feel those muscles tighten, relax. So you're feeling the muscles tightening at the upper portion of the back, down to shoulder blade level, maybe a little below shoulder blade level. More upper, definitely. Where most of the feeling is. The shoulder blades coming in toward each other, just kind of really pinching inward. Okay. Arms forward. One elbow bends, the other arm stays straight. So the arm that goes up to the side, pretty good reach there. A little work here for the muscles across the chest, but not a whole lot. Shoulders here as well. So anything that's bringing the arm forward is work for the muscles across the chest. Anything that's taking the arm backward, work for the muscles in the back. And even the non-moving, or what appear to be non-moving, your entire back is working on this, well, the entire core, so far as that's concerned. Standing up nice and straight. Bring those arms down. Just kind of get that rope in so that you just let the arms swing. You're just going across in front of the body, shifting the weight one foot to the other. So we need a little more work for the shoulders. Sit down. seat. Let your hands turn so that the palm is actually kind of facing right in toward the front corner of the chair. That way that weight isn't the touch on the chair. If you're not working with weights, all we're doing is a simple shrug. And rather than having the hand facing the sides of our leg or hip or chair, we have it kind of angled a little bit. This shoulder, opposite leg extending forward. But what that does is add a little more work for the core, for the muscles, hip to shoulder. So what we're trying to do is keep the torso, keep the core very well controlled. We're not wigwagging side to side. We don't necessarily think about that as exercise, but it is. Because what we're doing is strengthening. I'm going to switch sides here. So, first of all, we've taken away a good part of our support by having that one foot all the way forward. And that foot is relaxed, by the way. The knee is straight, the foot is relaxed. So, if we weren't holding on for dear life from hip to shoulder, we would just be kind of, looking like a shivering pile of pudding. So, or, on the other hand, I know it's early and you didn't mention it, but if that shivering pile of pudding went a little bit farther, it would begin to look more like a melting scoop of ice cream. Okay, bring the feet in, cross the ankles, let those weights hang in your hands. So again, if you're not using weights, no big deal. Just let the arms hang down. So, with ankles crossed, again, we've changed the amount of support that we have for our seated position. And keep your thumbs clear if you're working really close to the front corner of the chair. You don't catch the thumb between the chair and the weight. So, a little something different for the shoulders. The shrugs are the same no matter what your position is, no matter whether you're standing or seated. But here you're working from your seated position. So it's like if you're standing, you may or may not have a little bit of adjustment in your posture, in your seated position, in your standing position. Here, there's not very far you can go because we've taken the legs out of this, other than the fact that they're helping to support us a little bit. But if we were standing, we might be, tilting to the side a little bit. If we're sitting and we're very concerned about that straight seated position, we're probably not going to get any wigwag at the waist. So, probably working just a little bit harder. Not necessarily what you would expect. We've just taken a regular grip here. Still across those ankles, but we're going to stretch the legs. Knees are almost completely straight. That should get those shoulders pretty well loosened up. We're going to put the feet apart. We're going to go right into a seated bicep curl. And we'll just put that one weight down right between the feet. Actually, I want to get the elbow in against the inner side of the thigh here. Just some nice curls. other one and switch arms. Free arm is exactly that. It's free, it's relaxed, it's not doing anything. Kind of hanging along the outer side of your knee. Keeping your neck straight, which means that you're looking down toward the floor, a little bit forward, on a forward slant. So again, we're going to switch hands. We're going to switch weights. So did you notice that as you switch those weights, you have to fold in a little bit tighter in order to get down far enough with that hand to reach the weight. So it's just change the stretch over the back of the hip. Keeping your wrists straight, keeping your neck straight, but relaxed. Don't let it tense up. Again, we're going to switch hands, switch weights. Be sure that elbow is in against the inner side of the thigh, not resting on it. Shoulders should be pretty much even, straight across. Don't lift your head back too much. Just kind of keep the neck straight. Imagine the line that your spine has formed, the angle at the hip, and then just try to keep your neck straight. Not head lifted backward, but not head dropping forward either. Last two. Lift this arm. Put that weight down and switch over again. Each time you switch, be aware that you're putting a little different stretch in the back of the hip and at the lower back. And again, shoulders are level across. Other weight. Arms are hanging here. You can feel the stretch over the base of the hip. Gently start to come up to sitting straight. Let your hands just rest gently, just above the knee. So, does this seem like it should have any cardio effect? Well, minimal. But the fact is, we're dealing with the farthest extremity, feet and ankles, farthest away from the heart. So, even though we're not moving those feet fast or against any particular resistance, farthest away from the heart. So, sure is having a little bit of an effect. We don't have to beat ourselves to a pulp in order to work that cardiovascular system. So, we've got chest, back, shoulders, biceps, triceps. Oh, just let the arms hang. Weights or no weights, doesn't matter. Arms just hanging straight down. Triceps are at work. And in the meantime, we're keeping up that little motion with the feet. Seems inconsequential. Until, again, you look at it from the point of view that that's the farthest away from our heart. So it means that that system has to work. Okay, we're going to weights. We're going to take the legs forward. Raise the arms outward. So triceps are at work. Shoulders are at work. Bring the arms forward. So just spray need elbows is all it takes to work the triceps. Tricep is kicking into gear every time that elbow straightens. If you have any doubt, bring a couple fingers up. Try to feel the back of that arm. We'll slow it down. You can feel that muscle just absolutely tighten when the elbow straightens. Okay, let's go to the opposite arm. We'll keep both feet forward for now. Good strong support. That's always what we need. If we're going to stand or sit, so get those feet positioned and up. Just a little bit of motion with the feet. Be sure of where that chair is. We're going to sit back down. Not too many times. Maybe two more. Definitely going to stand up again. Use your hands on your knees. It helps. Anything to come up from sitting in a chair, back down again. So, most important, foot placement. Be sure you have those feet just a good length, good width apart. Make sure your weight is evenly on the entire length of the foot. This is all stuff that we pretty much do automatically, but if you become very conscious of it, it's going to be helpful. And again, hands on the knees, hands lifting forward a little bit, whatever helps. Get your back up to standing comfortably. We're not going to sit back down right now, just so you know. We need some work for the muscles across the chest. So, we'll take the roll. Here, we don't have a whole lot farther to go before we're going to be very over extended. our balance, our comfort point. Put that rope down for a minute. Just have a good vigorous motion with the arms, a little more determination with the feet. So, work for the chest, work for the shoulders, a little work for the back here. While we're getting this little bit of cardio, and again, cardio does not have to be so vigorous that you come off it feeling as though you can barely breathe. Just needs to be a good amount of motion. Okay, for the back. If you start with the arm forward, just take it around as far as you can without turning the shoulders. So as far around as you can. Turning. Your choice as to whether you kind of get that anchor hand on the thigh or not, it's not necessary. It maybe emphasizes the work a little bit. You can feel that down around the rib cage. You know you're going to work for the muscles in the back when you feel it around the back of the rib cage. And of course that, I mean this is for muscles in the back, but it's also for the shoulder, obviously. So shoulders are faced forward. Turning to the side. Now, if we want to get a little more involvement with those muscles, probably get feet a bit apart. And then this time, you do turn. Follow that hand with your eyes. Get on around the back. Changing the position of your hand on your head, but turning it enough to watch that hand. So what's happening is that even though the shoulders are turning as well, you're still doing this kind of a turn. Pretty slow, just let those shoulders relax. Side to the other. Does that mean that the shoulders are or aren't involved? Because the shoulders are definitely involved here. Also muscles, upper portion of the back, back of the shoulder, each of those head turns. Let's give it some nice work right there. Arms swing a little bit, a little roll with your feet just to keep moving. So we've gotten chest and back, but actually we've gotten some pretty good work with the shoulders as well. Just to loosen them up nicely. Nice big roll. Keep the arm relaxed, keep the elbow pretty straight. Let their arm hang. Shoulder rolls and shrugs, both, you know, invaluable for maintaining range of motion for the shoulder. To be comfortable. Any big move. Forward, upward, downward, backward. Straight upward, forward, and back down. The shoulder can move in so many ways. And actually, the more ways that it can move, so up to the side, this point, the more ways that it can move, the more possibility there would be for problems. So that's why we try to keep all possible angles. Started work for the biceps. Anytime we have this chugging motion, so that chugging goes this. So that chugging motion definitely gets some work going for the shoulders and obviously for the biceps. Now, the popcorn roll that brings your hands forward, just roll one forearm around the other. Because the elbow is bent, there is some work for the biceps. It's not. It's more of pulling that bicep into a working position and then keeping it there, as opposed to the chug, which especially if we slow it down, you realize that that bicep is going to work and then it's relaxing. Work for the biceps. Actually, let's see. Just kind of let one forearm slide over the other. So here again, biceps are actually at work for the entire time here. So we're not giving, even though it's not a difficult move, we're not giving them any rest. So the biceps get their rest when the arms straighten. And whether or not we have weights, whether or not we're working against any type of resistance, anytime the elbow's bent, it's those biceps to work. So something as simple as just, you know, bringing the hands in to just kind of touch the power. So heels together means knees are outward. So that arm now is slanting outward. Such a minor difference. And again, we're looking at the difference between moving part and non-moving part. And you know, anyone observing is not going to realize that there's a difference here. They're not going to know how much more work we're doing with the thigh, with those knees together. Because it's going to look exactly like this with the knees apart. So it does make a difference. Okay, we're going to take those feet forward. Heels apart, toes together. So again, it turns the hip joint. It doesn't do a lot of turn at the knee, really, because the leg is basically straight. So the turn we're getting is at the hip. Set the feet on their heels. Just a little raise. And again, toes together. Feel some kind of odd stretch along the outer side of the hip. Well, those heels are a fair distance apart, so the toes really are dropped in over them. Got to get a little more bicycling. Four. This is a slow speed. It's not unbearably slow, but it's pretty close. The difference between this and working more rapidly, this has a significant amount of hang time for the leg. It's kind of slowing its motion. So you can't really depend that much on momentum. It's a little too slow to have momentum be a help. Which doesn't mean that the movement is not continuous. It is. But, you know, they can't really just kick it into gear and then pulse the rest of the way. This one, each time you move that leg around, each time it's worked. So one more set of four with each leg. Because actually that seated bicycling appears pretty relaxed and easy. It's anything but. Okay, just rest on the heels. Legs are straight. Just very gently slide the hands down just far enough so the heel of the hand clears the round of the knee. So that's enough forward then. Then you can feel a nice relaxing stretch at the back of the hip. You want your feet relaxed, toes down, you know, relatively close to the floor. You want the knees straight. You want a minimal amount of pressure from the hands onto the shin bone because you don't want to jam those knees straight. But just take time for that stretch to settle in. And then come on back up to sitting. Okay, hands around the front of the shin. Little bit of a pull with the hands, but not so much to squeeze the knee as to get the knee a little bit tighter. So stretch over the back of the hip. And this kind of a stretch, we're all just going to hold for several counts. And then set that foot down. Same thing opposite side. So again, not so much to squeeze the knee, but to get it a little bit higher. Getting that knee up a little higher is what puts the stretch over the base of the hip. So, getting up to a standing position, just remember that you want your feet firmly planted. And hands on the knees, arms lifting forward. So anything that helps you to get up from a seated position and feel well balanced. Feel a little bit farther apart. Bring the arm out to the side and up, just straight overhead. Feel the stretch along that side. Same thing out there. Remember to help that elbow this morning. Weight on this one foot. Now, opposite foot turns more sideward. Has the heels slightly lifted. Same thing opposite side. So weight bearing side is the side that has the arm raised. Non-weight bearing or minimal weight bearing has the heel lifted. Bring that arm down. Shoulders roll, loosen them up a little bit. Just a nice shrug. Nice pat on the back. Thank you to those who are here in the class. Thank you to those of you who are at home. One more nice stretch, one more nice deep breath, and we will be together again on Thursday.